Hello and welcome to Maths with Jay. In this video, we're going to be looking at square numbers. We're going to be looking at what they are and how we can visualise them. I'd like you to start off by looking at this pattern. What do you notice? You may have noticed how many tiles there are altogether. There are in fact 9 rows and 9 columns, so altogether there are 81 tiles. We can see that this is a way of representing 9 times 9, or 9 to the power of 2, 9 squared, and 9 squared is 81. You may also have noticed that there is a pattern. In fact, the way I constructed this pattern was to start at the top left-hand corner. I started with a single blue tile. So we could think of this as a way of representing 1 times 1 is 1. Then I added 3 pink tiles. So in total, I've now got 4 tiles. And we can see that we've got a 2 by 2 square, which is represented by 1 plus 3. Then I added on 5 lime green tiles to get a 3 by 3 square. And you can see that 3 times 3, which is 9, is also 1 plus 3 plus 5. And you could see that a 4 by 4 square is represented by 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 and so on. To get 5 by 5 or 5 times 5, I would need to add 9 on to the previous number. So each time I'm adding on the next odd number. So that when we get to the big square that we started with, the 9 by 9 square, we can see that that's the sum of the odd numbers from 1 up to 17. And you can see that any square number can be represented by the sum of odd numbers. So the square numbers are 1, 4, 9, 16, and so on. And each of those can be written as a sum of odd numbers. In fact, we can see that 9 squared is equal to the sum of the first 9 odd numbers. And going back to 2 squared, that's the sum of the first 2 odd numbers, 1 plus 3. Now, mathematicians like to generalise things, so rather than just saying that any number multiplied by itself is the sum of however many odd numbers, it's easier to use a letter to represent the number we're thinking about. And as it's a whole number, we often like to use the letter N, so that a square measuring N by N, where N represents any whole number, could be written as the sum of the first N odd numbers. So remember, we've seen that that works for the numbers from 1 up to 9 squared, but you could see that each time you want to get the next square number, you'd need to add on the next odd number. So remember that N could represent any number at all. It could represent 3 or 9 or 1008 or 10 million. It could represent any number at all. Oh, and if you haven't done any algebra yet and don't know what I'm going on about, don't worry about it. The important thing about this video is the square numbers. So let's write down the first 10 square numbers. From the pattern that we've got here, we've got the first 9 square numbers. And we can see that if we want the next one, we'd have to add on another 19, and that would give us 100. Or another way of thinking of that is that 10 times 10 is 100, so 100 is the 10th square number. So there are two ways of getting the square numbers. Either we know our times tables, or we're using a calculator, and we can write down a square number given 3, for example, 3 squared is 9. Or if we're writing the square numbers in a list like we are here, we could just add on the next odd number to get the next square number, like we've done here. So we've got a good understanding of what square numbers are. If we multiply any whole number by itself, we get a square number. And if we had that number of square tiles, we could arrange them into a square. You may be surprised to hear that we could actually use square numbers, or see square numbers, in other patterns, in other shapes, not just in square shapes. So let's have a look at an example where we're using triangles. So let's start with a single triangle. I'm using an equilateral triangle here, so all the sides and all the angles are the same as each other. Then I'm going to add on 3 yellow triangles, and you can see that my 2 by 2 by 2 triangle has got 4 little triangles in it. And remember, 4 was our second square number. And then if we add on another row of triangles to make a bigger triangle, a 3 by 3 by 3 triangle, we now have 1 plus 3 plus 5 triangles, so we have 9 triangles. And if you continue this pattern, you'll see that, again, this is a demonstration of odd numbers adding up to square numbers. You might like to try another shape and see if you can demonstrate the same pattern, where we've got odd numbers adding up to square numbers.